Hello everyone, welcome to a new episode of Let's Talk. My name is Sasha Monis and in today's video we have with us Ms. Divya Dhawani. She is MBA finance student for the batch 2019-2021. She is also the vice president of Indradhanu Club and a sporting personality.
Yes.
How do you maintain balance between college work and other activities?
Okay. So, well, scheduling, dedication, and prioritization helps me a lot to balance all like I just was dancing and cooking. So, what I do, I just make prioritize things. If I'm having my exams, I won't go for that. So, main basic thing with
So that's amazing. Moving on to our next question. According to you, what are the key skills do you think a MBA finance student should develop to work efficiently in finance industry?
In these 2 years, I learned that finance is like keeping yourself updated. You have to update yourself with every basic change in the market. So hunger to learn. Market awareness, analytical skills, and communication skills. These 4 skills, I feel, are more important.
Okay. So, being on the same grounds as we juniors are going to start with our SIP. So, in few days. So, what are your recommendation and tips for us, as well as what was your experience and learnings?
Experience. So, first, I was initially in Motilal Oswal. But due to COVID, they just revoked it. So I just got another company named Globe Expand Solution. And it literally took me like 15 days to digest the fact that I'm not into first internship. I'm going into the second internship. This was my biggest limitation during my SIP tenure. And after that, in Globe Expand Solution, it was a good experience. Like we used to work in a team. Like team of 18 to 20 people. It was really a good experience. There we used to work on insurances, financial planning and so. And coming to the project, for that you need to choose the right topic and which should be relevant to your finance domain. When coming to the topic, my topic, I literally rejected 6 to 7 topics to come on the particular topic which I chose. I rejected 6 to 7 topics which I was working on. After that, and I would like to thank, I can't thank Varsha ma'am enough for guiding us in such a way that we could do our SIP projects and internships in such a good manner. She has guided us so well that my topic was one of the best topic I could say. And it was just because of Varsha ma'am. And when coming to the project, so you need to choose the right topic, right test, and whether it's primary research or secondary research, you need to identify it well. And choosing, when you are coming to primary research, you need to choose a correct test for it. Like we have T-test, chi-square test, and many more. So you need to choose the correct test for it. And your conclusions, your findings should be very much relevant. And main part of the project is literature review. That should be done like anything. You should spend more and more time on your literature review. The more you spend on your literature review, your project will be that much easier. So this will be the best.
Thank you for this tips. We'll definitely keep it in our minds. So the next question is, any memory that you have with your friends or faculty which you will cherish for life?
So with friends, I will cherish each and every moment. That's you can relate to it.
Yeah,
I'm sure. So when coming to the faculty, so it was our Antaram, it's a social gathering of MIT SOM. So we were practicing for a fashion show. I have participated in that. I was playing Naina from YJHT. So it was our last practice and Priyanka ma'am and Vinita ma'am, Vinita Kale ma'am and Priyanka Kukatnur ma'am came to see like what are we exactly doing. So she just called, she asked one of the senior to call me. So I was so scared. Did I do something wrong or so? I was like that. Oh God, what did I do? Okay, I was like that. So when I went to her, I met her. So she was like, "You're doing really, really well. Like, you did it amazing. I want everyone to do like you." I was like, "Okay, thank you." So that was the thing. And on a day when we were performing, when I came down from stage. So she, when I met her, she just hugged me like, "You did it really well. I'm so proud of you." And that was the best memory of the that whole year. Like getting so much approval from a faculty, like getting hugged from her, that was really a big thing for me.
Yeah, that's really amazing. So let's so now you're going to end your trimester 6 very soon. So I would like to ask how this 2 years of MBA have shaped you professionally as well as an individual?
Talking about, I can definitely say MBA groomed every single one of us in and out. Like, and it has built us a better person. It has shown us a better version of ourselves. It helps in developing soft skills like transferable skills, and which definitely make us market ready. So these are the main skills, and it definitely helps us in building our analytical, critical and decision making skills. Like when you are when you're doing MBA now, before that you are not that good. Like physical appearance also, that we are not that groomed. And once we are done, once we are like into our MBA or about to complete our MBA, so at that time you just are like so analytical person, like you can make decisions quickly. You can definitely make decisions quickly. I bet you on this. I bet, I can bet everyone on this. Once you'll pass out your MBA now, you can like the main skill which you'll develop is decision making skill. Like you are aware, you are matured enough now to make quick decisions.
So now we'll move on to the next segment, and that is a rapid fire. Okay, so you have to answer as soon as you can. Okay, so you are ready?
Yes.
Okay, all right. So my first question is, one quote you live up to?
Nothing is new under the sun.
Okay, describe yourself in 3 words.
Enthusiastic, dedicated, caring.
Yeah. Your role model?
I myself.
That's nice. Finance minister you admire the most?
Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru.
One thing about the college campus that you miss?
This is like quite obvious, Indradhanu events.
Okay. Any favorite dish from the canteen?
Masala pav.
If you could turn back time, then in which year would you love to relive?
2019.
Okay. So that was our round, and it was really fun. So as we have reached to the end of this interview, any special message to our MIT students?
To you, I seriously feel bad that you guys cannot go on the campus, but I would definitely make friends, make memories online. It is possible. Even we had done this. Like first year was on campus, and now second year we did it all online. But at this time also, we could make friends, like make memories online, and yes. Keep updated yourself, like update yourself every single day. So may it be technical knowledge or theoretical knowledge, anything it may be, keep update, be updated, like keep on updating yourself. That's
it. Thank you so much Divya for coming and joining us. We definitely had a good time.
Thank you so much for having me, and yes, thank you.